ओके डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वी विल कंटिन्यू लेक्चर नंबर 29 ऑफ इवोल्यूशनरी बायोलॉजी। इन दैट वी विल सी अ न्यू चैप्टर और न्यू यूनिट, मैक्रो इवोल्यूशन। मैक्रो मीन्स लार्ज, और वी कैन से ग्रेट इवोल्यूशन। दैट मैक्रो इवोल्यूशनरी प्रिंसिपल्स इंक्लूड्स द डार्विन्स फिंचेस। डार्विन हैज स्टडीड ऑन सम फिंच बर्ड्स ऑफ द आइलैंड्स ऑफ गैलापागोस एंड रिपोर्टेड मॉडिफिकेशन और डेवलपमेंट ऑफ big in different finch birds as bird eating or fruit eating or likewise, and reported that about the macro evolution. So macro evolution genetically refers to evolution above the species level, and so instead of focusing on an individual beetle species, a macro evolutionary lens might require that we zoom out on the tree of life. Means the genetic setup and the different animals in that particular group and the specific development in that particular animal is reported to access the diversity of the entire beetle clade and its position on the tree. This macro evolution can be studied very well. So this is the picture here, that the arthropod macro evolution is shown in this figure, and in this group the larger than the individual species, because individual species is a single, but it has two groups. In that two groups, one group have a 4-5 species. In second group there are again two divisions, again they have 5-6 species. In that again they have two species, of them one species have more than 10-12 species. In this way, this is the great diversity in the beetle species occurs on earth. In the diversity, therefore the macro evolution refers to the evolution of groups larger than an individual species. Suppose one species have a single, but it's a more group, or two groups having one group have more species. This might be the macro evolution. Then the three domains, the life, the history of life on the grand scale, are the bacteria, eukaryota, and archaea. So these are the three main groups or the three main domains from which all living beings are developed or radiated from the single origin. So macro evolution encompasses the grandest trend and transformations in evolution, such as the origin of mammals and radiation of flowering plants. So this is not necessarily to see the macro evolutionary history, but when we have find that from the figure, they originated from a single, and the mutation or recombination or genetic changes occurs, and and the large and the development of the animals, either insects or flowers, found in a large scale in the patterns of the history of life. The basic evolutionary mechanism includes mutation, migration, genetic drift, and natural selection, and can produce major evolutionary change if given through time. Now, what are the genetic or the general principles of macroevolution? First, macroevolution follows the acquisition of new general adaptation or entrance into a new adaptive zone. For example, Darwin's finches radiated after an apparently generalized finch ancestor. Second, macroevolution always involves revolutionary divergence. Then adaptive radiation or macroevolution tends to reproduce or tends to produce evolutionary lines that converge in special adaptation in that particular animal. For example, food habits of the fishes, then swimming pelagic life and free swimming pelagic life. Ichthyosaurus is the group which shows these changes and evolutionary adaptations. Then macroevolutionary process groups of all parallel species adaptation among divergent but related stock, and all of them have a common general adaptations. For example, the phytosaurus or Triassic animals of the order Codontia and crocodiles of the Triassic and recent. Crocodiles are very well developed and very successful animals on the earth. They are, since Triassic period to the recent time, they are well surviving in the ecological cycle or in the evolutionary chain. then macroevolution ultimately leads to the extinction. And some groups acquired special adaptations for narrow adaptation adaptive subzones, and due to these specialized adaptations, they could not move into major zones. So this mutation, gene flow, genetic drift, or natural selection, plus 3.8 billion years of the animal group, and this is called as macroevolution equation, is equal to macroevolution. So it takes much time, millions of billions of years, and these are the changes that takes place, macroevolution. A process like mutation might seem to all scale to influence a pattern of pattern as amazing as the beetle radiation, because beetles radiation in adaptive radiation in beetles, or the radiation of evolutionary group of beetles is quite great than any other animals. So biogeography, differences in species over geographic space, example Darwin's finches in the Galapagos Island. These are the Darwin finches in the Galapagos Island. They are showing a broad beak with a stout beak folds. Then this is quite narrow, this is very small beak, and this is very pointed and long small beak. So these are the differences in the beak modifications studied by Galapagos Islands. Then the fossil records differences in the species over time. Best example is the skeletal structure of horse lineage. So that we have already studied in the development of horse, Eohippus, Prohippus, Mesohippus, and Hippus or Equus. So these are the bones, radius, ulna, and tibia, fibula. This arrangement of the bone is showing the development in the feet or toes at the base. So these are the best examples in the macroevolution. And the comparative anatomy of the human, dog, bird, and whale shows that the same bone arrangement, skeletal arrangement is same, only the length is different and the arrangement is different, but the names and structure or the basic pattern is the same. So radius, ulna, tibia, fibula, phalanges, everything is similar. So this is the comparative anatomy, and the analogous structure shows that there are multiple lineages, either in the from fishes or from small fishes to the large whales, then birds, dogs, and humans. So these are the changes that occur in the development or evolution. So vestigial structures. Some animals have the structures on their body, but they are reduced, called as vestigial structures. So remnants of the structures that used to serve a purpose, but which no longer do so, thus giving clues to an organism's ancestry. Example, the vestigial hind limbs of whales, the non-functional eyes of cave-dwelling fish, the pectoral and pelvic vestiges in snakes. So these are the vestigial organs in snakes, fishes, and other animals, or even in whales. So artificial selection, in artificial selection, the directional selection imposes on the species by humans for a desired outcome. Example, selection on dogs to create breeds as distinct as the Chihuahua and the Great Dane. Selection on farm animals for greater yields of milk, meat, fur, eggs, etc. A great example from agriculture is the range of varieties created from Brassica oleracea, the wild mustard plant, including cabbage, kale, kohlrabi, Brussels sprouts, cauliflower, and broccoli. So here we will have a small break, and then we will continue later on the macro.